Celebrities, politicians and dignitaries all gathered to farewell the man affectionately known as Moonface. 500 friends, colleagues and family filled the pews of St Patrick's Cathedral to say goodbye to Bert Newton.
I've lost a dear friend, a friendship that has endured over 60 years.
Pete Smith read moving tributes on behalf of Bert Newton's son Matthew and daughter Lauren. His son revealed the last conversation he had with his father only days before his death, where he poked fun at his wife Patty.
And the second she left, Dad leaned into the phone camera and whispered, "I think she's poisoning my food, Matthew." Well, we both laughed and laughed until we cried.
There was plenty of reflection on his good humour and his generosity even away from the spotlight. Eddie Maguire recalled how he visited a stranger who was dying of HIV/AIDS at a time when people with the illness were stigmatised.
Not only did Bert visit and spend hours with every person in the ward, but gave the man one of his beloved gold logies.
Victorian Premier Daniel Andrews telling the crowd that Newton was a man every Australian felt they knew.
Like a fireplace on a cold night, families would gather around their TV sets, drawn in by Bert's warmth and sustained by his inviting ease. Bert was more than talent. He was trust.
His daughter Lauren also sharing the less public side of her father.
When I was a little girl, I always felt I was so lucky. I had two dads, one on TV and one at home. He was the same funny, warm, wonderful person everyone watched on TV, but at home he was even better.
Guide us with your grace.
The common theme though throughout the service was the love between Bert and his wife of nearly 50 years, Patty.
And while there was Bert and Graham and Bert and Don, there was nothing like Bert and Patty. What a combination. Patty, you shared your husband with us all. There would always have been a Bert, but he was enhanced so much by his Patty.
The service also reflecting his deep Catholic faith, his grandchildren delivering the prayers of the faithful. And as the boy from Fitzroy made his final exit, those he cherished the most were beside him till the end. Gloria Kleisch, SBS World News.